Welcome to a new video about drawing and animation. Today, we will see how to make an animation based on a high-quality and detailed character or a static image. It can be a photo or simply a drawing created by you. We will learn how to separate each part, how to redraw, and how to put everything together using bones on Moho. With this technique, you will be able to create animations, test for character movements, and since some people have asked me about how to do a South Park-like animation, well, this would be a good start. Remember to activate the subtitles if you need them, and for more information, check out the video description. Okay, before I start, I want to thank all the messages of support I received, and I want to thank you for your patience and understanding for the delay in creating a new video. I had some really crazy weeks, but at the same time, I had time to prepare new ideas for new animations, drawings, and new Moho tutorials for every level. As you can see, I already have my character created. You can make a screen print to copy it and follow the same steps with me. I chose this character since he has quite complex edges, but don't worry because if you manage to prepare this character, the others will be much easier. So let's get started. First, select the layer that contains our image, then click on Select, and then click on Subject. Okay, we already have the selection created. Now let's select the tool, Quick Selection Tool, and then we'll position ourselves over our image. Right-click to open the menu, and then the option Select and Mask. As you can see, this will give us the possibility to create various types of masks. We will work with the overlay mask or letter V. In this case, we will work with a green background, so you can choose it by clicking on the color option. And remember to use the opacity in 100%. Once you have the background color, you can choose the tool, Refine Edge Brush Tool, or letter R. With this tool, we will be able to clean the edges of our character, eliminating the white background of the most complex parts. Okay, now activate the tool, Decontaminate Colors, and we will leave it at 50%. Then in the Output option, we will select the option, New Layer with Layer Mask. Once you are done, click OK. As you can see, now we have a new layer with our character and his mask. Well, in my case, I am going to use a darker background. This will help us to see the edges and find if there are any flaws. Once we have a darker background, we will be able to find the errors more quickly. Okay, here we have a good example. To fix it, select the eraser tool, or letter E, and delete everything that is not necessary. In a moment, we will see how to draw our own hair to improve these details. Now with the tool, clone stamp tool, or letter S, we can clone different parts of the drawing. To do so, simply select the hair you want to clone by selecting Alt and left click, and then paint where necessary. The cloning technique is very useful and helps us to avoid having to cut and paste or redraw certain parts. Okay, we'll repeat the same process on the right hand. First, we will remove what is not necessary, and then we will fix the hair. Once you have your character finished, we can remove the extra layers. I am simply going to duplicate it. Select both layers, and then I will click on Merge Layers. Now we have our character in a layer completely clean and without a background. Okay, let's stop for a second because now we're going to need a brush to draw hair. But don't worry, I'm gonna leave in the description some links where you can download several free brushes. I recommend that when you go to install your new brushes, you create folders for each group. Then you'll see your folders organized inside Photoshop with all your brushes. I have several folders with brushes that I have been collecting over time, or even brushes that I have been creating. If you want to know how to create custom brushes in Photoshop to work with characters that you will later use in Moho, let me know in the description and then I will make a special video to answer that and other questions you may have. Okay, once you have your hairbrush selected, try it out. See if it's similar to our character's hair. Then if you want to copy some colors, just select your brush, then click Alt and position your mouse or your pen over the color you want to copy and click it. Doing this, we can draw using the same colors that our character has. It is very simple. And by doing this, we will achieve a greater similarity. Try to fix as many parts as possible. The idea of drawing the extra hair is to make the edges look natural. In the case of working with characters that have no hair and only clothes, you may need other types of brushes to create similarities with their textures. Now we will see how to work in those cases. First, let's adjust the colors by clicking on the Create New Fill or Adjustment Layer tool, located at the bottom of our Layers panel. Select the Selective Color option and here adjust the colors if necessary. This step is not mandatory, but it is always good to adjust the tones if we see that the character does not have the colors we want. In the same way, we can select the brightness and contrast. Once we finish adjusting these details, if you wish, we can select all the layers by right-clicking and merge. Here we can see what it looks like before and after. This means that our character is ready. Now we must divide it into parts, and each cut will depend on the animation that we want to do in Moho. So, select the cutting tool, polygonal lasso or letter L, and let's get started. In my case, I just want to animate both legs, both arms, and his head. If you want a more detailed animation, you can also cut the gloves and every part that is necessary. Then we will work with the bones in Moho to join each part. For those who are new or for those who don't use Photoshop much and want to learn more, let me know in the comments and I'll prepare an exclusive video with some tips about Photoshop and characters. Okay, once you've cut the arm, you can move it around to get an idea of what its animation will look like. As you can see, to draw the neck, I use the clone stamp tool and the hairbrush. It doesn't have to be perfect, just analyze how your character will move and draw or complete whatever is necessary. In other words, everything that will be visible must look good. Once you have all the parts on different layers, don't forget to name them. This is very important because the name of each layer will later appear in Moho. Okay, now we have our character completely separated. Let's make a test and let's try to move the arm. To move each part of the body, just select the layer you want to move and then select Command-T on a Mac or Control-T on Windows, then move it or rotate it to test it. If we move the arm back, this could be a huge problem in the animation because it will leave the armor visible and it is not complete. But don't worry, this can be fixed very easily. So, let's see what we can do. Now that we know how to use the Cut and Clone tool, we will use them for this and for any future model. But first, let's see what is the best option in this case. As we know, to clone any part of the character, we just have to select the clone stamp tool. Click on Alt and then right-click to select the part that we want to clone, and then just paint. Let's try that. As we can see, this sector of the armor is too dark and cloning may not be the best option. That's why I'm going to select another part of the armor and cut it by selecting it. And then clicking Ctrl-X to cut and Ctrl-V to paste. Then select the new piece and click Ctrl-T to activate the transform option. To adjust the shape, just press right-click to open the menu and select the warp option. This technique allows us to adjust the piece until it is aligned with our main armor. Okay, once the new piece is in the right place, we can now delete the leftover parts of the main armor. Just try to unify both and delete everything that is not necessary. Now let's talk about another technique that can be useful to complete parts. First, select the armor and then select the smudge tool. For the type of brush in this case, I will use a round one. You can use another brush depending on the texture or shape of the character you are working with. Okay, now what you are going to do is very simple. You will click on the armor and begin to move the brush, as if we were painting by pushing the colors. Then with the erase tool, you will delete everything that is not necessary, and that's it. If you want to add an extra detail, we could add a little shadow to this part to make it look more realistic. Choose a painting brush and paint with a low opacity and a dark color over the armor. Then, if necessary, adjust details using the smudge tool again. Okay, now let's see what the arm looks like. Perfect. It seems complicated, but with only a few tools, we have completed a very complex armor. Now you are ready to apply this to other characters too. Once you are done, merge everything so you can have your armor in only one layer. To make it look even better, we can use the clone stamp tool again. But this time I'm just going to add more of these gold dots. These are just details, but it's important that you always push yourself to improve your characters to the point of saying, okay, this is what I was really looking for. Okay, to finish, let's do a little practice. Let's add a new part to our armor. First, just copy the one we already have by pressing Ctrl-C to copy and Ctrl-V to paste it. Now click Ctrl-T to move our piece. Then press right-click to open the menu and choose the warp option to adjust it. Remember that we are just repeating the same steps. Just keep practicing. Keep practicing the techniques and tools we used in today's video and try new things. Find your own way. Photoshop always offers us more than one way to do things. With time, you will find your own method. Now let's review the tools we've used so far. We used the lasso tool to cut or copy what we wanted. We then used the clone stamp tool to clone details, lines, and missing parts. We also used the smudge tool to adjust details and textures. And finally, we work using a painting brush to create shadows or hair. Practice with these tools and you will see that very quickly you will be able to divide and animate any type of character. If you got to this point in the video, I think you'll be interested in the next and last tool called Liquify. Go to the top menu and open Filter. Then choose Liquify. You will see that a new screen will appear only with our armor layer. This tool is used to make simple adjustments by pushing and pulling pixels in an image. Play around with each tool and you will see that it can be very useful. In this case, we will only use the first option called Forward Warp Tool, or the letter W. This tool will help us to adjust lines, borders, and everything that needs small adjustments. It is a very useful tool to adjust hair, skin, clothes, and any type of objects. There are no limits. I still remember one of my teachers. Every time I showed him a character, he used to say, "Work it a little more." Day after day, he always repeated the same thing, "Work it a little more." I remember that I didn't know what else to do. I had no idea what he wanted. Actually, he never told me what to change or what to improve, and that simple fact forced me to experiment. After several days of tinkering, I remember comparing the first and last model, and it was there, the perfect character, color, or pose that I didn't know I was looking for. It was right there. So remember, always push yourself to the limit, even when you think everything is ready. Once you are done, click OK. Perfect. We now have our finished armor. With these simple steps, you will be able to bring any photo, drawing, or object you want to life. As you can see, in my case, to have a better movement of the head, I divided it into two parts, a layer for the neck and another one for the head. What we saw is very basic, but it is the starting point, since if you practice with the tools that we saw today, you will be able to create much more complex characters. Once you have all your character ready, put the name on each layer and then erase the background and anything else that isn't necessary. To export the character to Moho, simply save it as a PSD. Moho will respect the names of each layer or folders if you have. In the next video, we will see how to apply the bone system in a very simple way to create an animation. Each step in an animation takes time. First the script, then the storyboard, the character creation, and then the animation. Be patient. Plan well what type of character you will use, analyze the action you are going to perform, and then draw what is necessary. Every animation will depend on your planning, and this will be essential to save time. Working with Photoshop and Moho will allow us to create characters with more details, more interesting backgrounds that we can then animate as well. As I mentioned before, Moho is a great tool for creating characters and video games in 2D for Unity or Unreal. But we'll talk about that in other videos. For those who are new to my channel, welcome. And for those who are already part of this family, thank you so much for being there. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and subscribe. Also, if you want, now you can send a super thanks to help me with the channel. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. Now it's time to practice, so I will see you next time.